slowly circle each other, tense and focused. You scan him for any sign of weakness, any opening in his defense that you could possibly exploit. He is no match for my might. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. It is I, the Golden Joeblivion. We're back with our man, Lord Paramount Eddard of the North, for what may be a very brief episode with our man. He is caught in the middle of a deadly duel with the Giant's Bane, Chief Tormund, the Giant's Bane of the Gorge, doing battle in the Shadow Tower. We are defending the wall from the Wildland invasions. And we are vastly outmatched by our opponent. The first round of dueling, we've been able to get the better of him by giving him a concussion, a blow to the head. Instead of trying to take his head off, we decided to slap him with our sword. We slapped him with ice, that giant greatsword that apparently is so heavy it can't be swung by a normal human being. But Lord Eddard is no normal man. Now, how are we going to do this? I think last time we used speed. We used speed because it seems to be the only advantage we have over Chief Tormund Giantsbane, because he's a lot stronger than us. I would say use a defensive stance, but he's the same skill level of fighting, the dual skill. So that might not work. I'm kind of leaning towards using speed again, but I think maybe I'm thinking too much about it. I'm probably thinking too much about this because I like to think that the AI is intelligent and will try to counter whatever we're trying to do, whether they're being defensive or attacking with strength. You know, maybe he had to, because his first attack, he used strength, and we were able to quickly evade that attack and hit him with a concussion. So maybe he's going to be a little bit more cautious now because he doesn't want to die. So he might just wait for us to come to him. But you know what? If he does die, Lord Eddard, it was a service. It was an honor serving you, sir. And little Rob here, Lord Rob, the incompetent commander. I mean, we can work on that. Oh wow, Robert Stark. Oh damn, a stillborn. Shit, that sucks. That would have been a very attractive northerner, wouldn't it? Look at that. He'd have been very attractive. But we will be playing as Master Rob of Moat Cailin, and we'll have to avenge Lord Eddard by killing the Giant's Bane. And he has his wife Marjorie Tyrell, so we now have a pretty firm alliance between us and the Reach. Well, we would have, but we've kind of pissed them off. Let's see. Lord Wyless stands to inherit the realm, so maybe we should start swaying him. Did we marry Sansa to Theon? Oh shit, we did. Damn, and he's not going to form an alliance with us because of political concerns, which means that I think he's planning on invading us. Well, hopefully that doesn't fucking happen. So we're going to actually try to sway Wyless Tyrell, the heir to the Reach, because right now Mace Tyrell has an infection in his face, so there's a good chance he won't survive. But this duel, this is of paramount importance at the moment. And I am going to do what I did last time, and I'm going to attack with speed. We will use speed, speed of hand, speed of mind. You attack with speed. One mistake is all he'll get. You see a weak spot, a vulnerability in Chief Tormund's defense. It's not much, but it's all you need. Strike! You easily break through Chief Tormund's guard and move to elegantly whack my ice into his hand. Oh, come on, Eddard. Come on, Eddard. Stop playing around. Stop toying with your prey and kill him. You strike and manage to get the better of Chief Tormund, but do not defeat him outrightly. Okay, so now he's got a swollen wrist, and he's got a concussion. He rises to his feet and readies his dagger once again. He's wielding just a dagger? Maybe that's why he's getting bested. He's had a concussion, he has a swollen wrist now, and Eddard can't seem to land a mortal blow. Now, Eddard has the advantage. Whew. As Chief Tormund faces you, you realize he's struggling with a wound. You scan him searching for any sign of weakness, but he stands resolutely ready to meet you. You know, maybe this is all part of Tormund's plan to lull Eddard into a sense of advantage, security. I aim for his wound. I want to keep using speed, but I'm kind of worried that eventually the AI is going to pick the thing that counters speed, which, oddly enough, I don't know what that is. I don't know which one of these actually counters speed. Because if you attack with strength, speed is better than that. To defeat speed, you can take a defensive stance, and to defeat defensive stance, you would use strength. Maybe now would be the time to use force. I know he's strong, but he's wounded. He's very wounded. We might be able to get the better of him, but this also might kill us. Well, we have to trust in the old gods. We have to trust that they want to see Lord Paramount Eddard best the Giant's Bane. So we will strike with force now. Your experience in combat and prowess with ice allows you to spot an opening in Chief Tormund's defense. It's not much, but it's all you need. I forcefully overwhelmed his... Okay, so he did take a defensive stance, probably because he thought we were just going to spam speed over and over and over again. So he finally took defensive stance. If we had taken speed, he would have countered us. But we tricked him in that we decided to use strength against him. I forcefully overwhelmed his defensive stance. I easily break through through his guard and elegantly smack my ice into the side of his head. How many concussions are you going to give this man, Eddard? End it. Chief Tormund drops his bastard sword. So his dagger is turned into a bastard sword now. And hastily retreats. I yield. Concussion, swollen wrist, black eye. Well, you know what? Chief Tormund, you didn't use any dirty tricks. You didn't try to cheat. And you took a lot of blows. And you stood your ground before finally giving up. And we are Eddard Stark. I accept. I accept your yield, sir. Back on your feet. The fight is over. Chief Tormund lies defeated. You have won. What an excellent, duel. Well, we will hold on to him as our prisoner for now, and then we'll probably release him. We'll probably release him eventually. Oh, come on. Your ability to take down any man in a brawl. Yeah, it's pretty amazing that Lord Eddard bested the Giant's Bane. And because we captured their commander, King Mance's forces should start to break. I have managed to sow distrust between Commander Humphrey of Dragongate and King Joffrey. Fantastic. Let's be merciful and put him in house arrest. But they're still beating us in this battle, which is kind of ridiculous. Yeah, King, even though we captured Chief Tormund. Oh, Eddard, you ran? Oh, that's not good. All right, we need more men. Bring them to Castle Black. Where are all our commanders at? What the hell's going on here? Captain of the Household Guard, let's disband our Household Guard, because that's taking up unnecessary funds to do such a thing. Court Jester, Master of Horse. Where are my commanders? Yeah, Master Tellman. Let's see. Well, Rob is in this army here. Do we have any organizers? No, we have nobody. All right, Mage, Hugo. Generally, everyone who's just chilling, not doing anything, you're going to take up the secondary army and go to the Brandon's Gift. And this army's going to retreat. Yep. Well, that's kind of shit. And then the Night's Watch are now heroically have set upon King Mance. Woo. Wyman is no longer Spymaster. He died a natural death. He died an honorable death. He died an honorable man. Can we build a fort here? No. Controls or besieges Craster's Keep. Okay, Eddard. Rob has... He's gone somewhere else. Let's go to White Tree and build a fort here. That's what we'll do. And then we need to replace Wyman as the Spymaster, that honorable man. We were supposed to reward him. We will reward House Manderly. Believe me, we're not going to make Lord Roos the Spymaster because fuck that. That's way too dangerous. House Manderly. Lord Wyless. I knew your father. He was a good man. Grant landed title. Award the Keeper of the Swans. There's not a whole lot we can do, and I'd love to give him some gold, but we're kind of broke at the moment. We're going broke, at least. We've got lots of armies heading towards the north. Good. Recently, I've noticed the pitiful state of my daughter, Lady Arya. She's got the flu. Call for a physician at once. And it seems the Night's Watch have somehow managed to defeat the rest of King Mance's forces. Maester Lewin. Nice. Wait a minute. What do you mean? Lord Commander Gjord the Bear has been imprisoned by Chief Walrus the Great. Gior got himself fucking captured. I don't really know what to say about that. That's really not how I had planned things on happening. Is there any way we can get him back? I don't think so. Let's see if we can try to plot to rescue. No. Let's go over here and see if we can. All right, we will try to intercept King Mance as quickly as we can before the war comes to an end. Oh, nope. He's changing course already. He's going to the Shadow Tower. Damn it. Damn it, Jor, you fool! My lord, his grace King Joffrey has taken his last breath. May he repose in peace. Now his heir, Prince Tommen Lannister, whom we know to be the clever lion cub, will take the throne and rule the Seven Kingdoms henceforth. What happened to him? Died under suspicious circumstances. He was murdered. The king was murdered. Well, you know, that works out in our favor. We have a new king we have to get on to the Iron Throne, but I think we have to deal with this war first. What is this? Invasion of the Wall. Invasion of the Night's Watch. Jor, you dumb, dumb bastard. You have just gave them the wall. A crow. Is Jor a warg? Possibly. Crow always follows this character. Interesting. He could very well be. Let's see. He's not... Let's wait till his movement gets locked on the 4th of... The 3rd of the 4th moon. Nope. He has taken the wall because Jor essentially has thrown it away to him. My king, we have had reports from the far north of Westeros that the wall has fallen to the wildlings. They attacked the wall in great numbers and have overwhelmed the defenses of the Night's Watch. Lord Commander Jor Mormont has taken the survivor south as trying to galvanize a counterattack. No, he's not. He's sitting in a fucking dungeon. What? He has eternally disgraced House Mormont. This is a great travesty. We must not allow this to happen. We will disband our forces and we will immediately begin mobilizing to retake the wall. We cannot have the wildlings control the wall because very soon they will cross the wall in huge numbers and they will invade the north. My friend Howland has invited me to a grand banquet. Why bother? All right, let's go. Let's go do that for now, I guess. Our conflicts have ended. We can be of service to our liege again. And he kind of likes us. Wait a minute. What is this? Lord Paramount Eddard, the realm is in a state of war and as such as I, your king, command you that you provide men to support my armies. What do you mean? Defending against Lord Paramount Renly of the Stormlands and Lord Paramount Renly of the Stormlands war for the Iron Throne. Let's see. King Tommen has the Vale, the Iron Isles. Now, here's the thing. We could aid Renly. Renly, do you not have any allies? No. Lady Paramount Alla, you have Alla. Okay, You've married Lady Paramount Alla, who is a Tyrell. We could, but we won't really have any money for that. We don't really have any money to help Renly, and I don't want to go broke. And we have our own wars to consider going forward. And Renly is vastly outnumbered right now. Just from the get-go, the Vale and Theon of the Iron Isles. We will, Shit. Is Stannis still alive? Who are you? You're defending against Renly. He is actually helping King Tommen. Maybe he just wants Renly to get out of the way. I don't know. What is House Tyrell doing? House Tyrell is doing nothing. We will do nothing as well. I'm more concerned about going bankrupt, in all honesty. And we need to worry about the Wildlands now, because we can't be fighting a two-pronged war. We have to secure the North first before we march back down south. But we are independent. Sort of. Again. Factions, Liege Loyalists, good. Good. Alright, take a loan. We're not going to do that. I was sitting beside Gianna at the feast. Now, though we had never really talked before we really hit it off, we ended up together in the garden with a couple of bottles of brown ale from Lord Howland's well-stocked cellar. I think I made a new friend. Okay, I kind of wanted to see what she looked like. Lady Gianna of the Neck. Ah, the wife of Howland Reed. Alright. Fair enough. Are we making more money? We kind of sort of are. We are at the moment. We must build up quite the war chest before we march back on the north. Retaking the wall. So is Jor Mormont is still the... Is he still... Ah, it's her brother. Wow, look at all these daughters. Alisane the She-Bear. I think we've married Jarell in the past, and she's given lots of children. Do they have a legendary bloodline? No, they don't. All right. But her brother, Lord Commander Jor Mormont, is imprisoned by King Mance in the Fist of the First Men. We have Tormund, who absolutely hates us, injured me in battle, in prison. This is true. Do you mind? Nope, you guys want to ransom us? Well, it would be the most honorable thing to let him live, to just release him, but he would fight again. You know what? He was honorable. We will do the honorable thing. We will release the giant's bane. We might fight him again in the future. We don't know, but it would be honorable to release him. Injured me in battle. Merciful. All right. So let me see. How long will injured me last? 83-16. Really? He's gonna... Oh, okay. So because we injured him in battle, that far outweighs the fact that we released him and didn't execute. Because here's the thing. Merciful is plus 20, and he'll forget about that in 83-11. So in 10 years, he'll forget about how we were merciful and released him. But he will remember that we injured him in battle for 15 fucking years. So apparently, injuring someone in battle is such a grievous insult that even being merciful and releasing them does not undo that. That's kind of ridiculous, in my opinion. That's kind of hard to believe. All right. Anyways, my lord, your son Rickon, is responding well to command, and we are back in Winterfell. Make that the focus. And we need to build up our treasury before we begin making plans. My lord, Newsom Caster, the Rock of a Trial by Combat, Sir Gregor Clegane demanded a trial by combat from his captor, Lord Paramount Tywin, and proved his innocence by slaying his opponent, Sir Lucian Lannister. Okay, apparently there's been some kind of falling out between Sir Gregor Clegane and or the Mountain and, oh god, the Faith Militant. Yeah, because that's what we need. That's what we fucking need. Your liege, King Mance Tall Talker. Alright. He does have the gonorrhea. He's got the pox. We can declare war and we can restore the Night's Watch. Chiefdom of Castle Black. City of Brandon's Gift. What does that mean? Either the Night's Watch has fallen to the Wildlands or the Lord Commander has broken their vows. If we were to restore the watch, the realm would be grateful. The wall shall be restored to Lord Commander Jor. I don't want to restore it to Lord Commander Jor because he gave it to them when he charged at the fucking Wildlings. Ooh, we can claim Brandon's gift. This Cassus Belli can be used by Lord Paramount Eddard to press Kyle Kostok's claim on the chiefdom of Brandon's gift. This would give him the city. I don't want to do that. That's kind of stupid. What are these different sigils? I don't understand. Great Shadow Cat, Ebarg, High Chiefdom of the Wall. Okay. Yeah, I'd like to restore the Night's Watch completely. All right. He's got 2,000 men. We have 31,000 men. We have 100 gold, so this war will have to be relatively quick. And apparently I got my ally, the Tullys, who will also aid us. But we cannot wait. We cannot let the Wildlands secure their foothold. We must retake the Night's Watch. Begin the march on the wall. All right. Call in our allies. We will call in our allies because this is a very honorable thing we need to do. We must retake the wall. House Mormont has forever disgraced themselves by losing the wall. Ooh. Maybe we should lead this army, or maybe we should have Rob lead it. Well, Rob's our son, though. Nah, let's have ourselves. We'll lead this army. We'll lead this army north, and we'll cut them off at the new gift. And I'd like to not raise the rest of my... Actually, you know what? We can be kind of cheesy here, and we can raise our vassals' armies and have them pay for it, which is, you know, kind of shit, but it's okay. Just march everybody to the borders and prevent the Wildlands from crossing down south. Go here to Shadowmoor. You guys will go on over to Last Hearth. You guys are all marching... Okay, then you southern guys are going to come here and go to Arendelle. And then this will allow us to make personal money while having armies march to the border. Dear son-in-law, of course I'll honor my obligations and answer a call to war. Excellent. I know you're kind of broke too, but we need all the support. So we should be making money because we're not raising our personal levies, but we were making essentially everyone else in the north fight for the Night's Watch, which I'm sure they'd be in favor of. After I told Brandon it was time to head on home, he looked at me with a grin on his face and told me to race him home, leaving me to carry everything on my own. Yeah. Racing him home? Is this some kind of sick joke? Race him. Lecture him about responsibilities. He may gain playful. I don't know if that's what we want. Do we want playful? Maybe. Brandon never seems to be grumpy, always playing without a care in the world. It will change. Well, maybe. Maybe. Brandon Stark. It's nice to see that all of our children are doing well. Sir Jon Snow, where are you? At court in the Fist of the First Men. Are you with the Wildlings? He's with the Wildlings. This is the Fist of the First Men, or is this the Fist of the First Men? I don't know. Whoa. Recently conquered administration, ruined castle of Queensgate. Okay, Castle Black. All right, I kind of panicked for a second because I thought maybe the Wildlings had come in here and destroyed all the castles. I believe that one of your vassals can be discouraged from associating with conspiratorial factions. I don't see any conspiratorial factions. Okay. Well, we're going to have to... Let's speed this up a little bit. Lord Cregan of Arendelle, I'm pleased to report that a majority of the population of Driftwood has converted to the old god's faith. They won't really like that, but they'll have to deal with it. Perhaps the time I asked Lord Wireless to spend some time with me is probably the fastest way for him to for me to gain his trust. Do it. As a future heir of House... Not House. The future heir of the Reach, this would be most beneficial. I think these days have really helped me getting Wireless to know and appreciate me better. We have passed most of our time in my palace discussing the most disparate topics. I hope you enjoyed our frugal dinners. Okay, I hope we can trust each other more now. It's because you have the honest trait. I hope we can trust each other more now. That seems like a good idea. We'll do that. We are both honest, Lord Wireless. And I have to say, I'm really, really fond of the green eyes trait. For some reason, I really dig the green eyes. And the hair is not bad either. Is this supposed to be like a light brown or more of a red? Looks more light brown. I dig it. I like it. All right. The armies are marching north. A Bravosi who claims to be a master bladesmith approached me and offered his services in teaching my ward. Lady Arya is a lunatic, which I think is very accurate to the show's representation of Arya. I do find her to be quite the lunatic. Cereal Pharrell. Iricho. No, it's Iricho. I thought he'd be Cereal Pharrell. All right. I'll pay you a price. I hope you're good as you claim. 20% chance she gets skilled fighter. And we lose 50 fucking gold for this. Why am I paying for Arya? I don't want Arya to become an assassin. I just want her to be the wife of Lord Sweet Robin. Lord Sweet Robin. All right, away with you, Bravosi. We don't need her to be an assassin. We need her to be a dutiful wife to the Vale. Okay, so I think... How many men do the Wildlings have? 3,000 at most. 3,000. Who is this? Lord Eckard of Breakstone Hill. We will do nothing for now. All right. We can begin moving on the wall. We will march from Shadowmoor. And how are we going to do this? Last Hearth has got 7,000 men. They've got 5,000 men of... Oh, don't disband them. Don't disband them. This army is here. These guys are going here. Do we have any more armies? No. So the Seal Shore is kind of a weak flank. I'm going to have Rob go with Mage and the Great John to the new gift. We're going to have this army led by... Let's see. We'll lead this army. We'll lead this army. We'll have Hugo... And we'll take Hellman, and we'll go to the Brandon's Gift. So these two armies going here together should be able to be supplied. We need to be very careful that we don't overwhelm ourselves with the supply limits. So we are launching an all-out invasion of the wall. Lord Rickard of Carhold, the Lord of Carhold, seeks to kill Arnulf Karstark. It's kind of concerning. And the invasion of the wall is underway. Excellent. Hey, that's easy. That's very easy. Invasion. And King Mance has taken up a very strong position on the Shadow Tower. A river flows between this county and Forktop and Craster's Keep. That's fine. We're not attacking from the north. We're attacking from the south. All right. So we're going to march this army on. We're going to get on the wall. Robert's going to take Brandon's gift. And... Rob's going to attack from the south. We'll attack from across the wall. We will be bottlenecked. We will be bottlenecked on the wall. But, we'll have to be brave about it. We'll be brave. All right, then get our reinforcements here. Everyone marching to the new gift. I will say, I do like the dynamics of fighting for the wall. It is very interesting. It's a really big bottleneck. And once you get north of the wall, it becomes kind of a bitch because the supply limits are virtually non-existent. And I think this is the bulk of their forces. So what we're going to do is we're going to have Rob attack from the south. And they'll get the bonus of mountains. And then we'll be attacking from across the wall. We'll probably force him to retreat. No, he's going to hold his position. He's going to be a... The brave fool is going to hold his position. No, he's going to... They're going to flee. And he waits till the movement gets fucking locked. And we're going to start taking attrition almost instantly. Really? They're going to get... That's sons of bitches. All right, the rest of you march to East Watch. Quite silly. But we have taken the wall. We will take the wall, at least. The wildlings are abandoning the wall. They see the legions of the north descending upon them. All right, so they're going to East Watch. Eddard's forces are moving back to Castle Black. We will secure the wall. And then we will have to ranger out north and kill King Mance. Once we do that, all of the wildlings will disband. They'll disband without a strong leader. Where are our reinforcements at? Where are they going to go? They're going to go to the new gift. All right. Lady Mage seeks to replace Howland Reed as Master at Arms. Well, Howland Reed is doing a fantastic job. All right, sieging the wall. That's the way I like to see it. Are we losing a lot of money? No, because we're not raising our personal levies. Brilliant. All right, what is the supply limit here? 20, so we'll move up to Brandon's gift so that we can support them. I am not at all concerned about the wildlings attacking us. Rumors of a traitor working within the besiegers has eroded the morale of the defenders of Castle Black. Good. It says attacker is Eddard. That's kind of weird. My lord, for some time I've been the employ of Lord Howland Quag. House Quag. Very, very odd sigil. We will not take you on, sir. So who will have the glory of marching out here? Where is Tormund? Chief Tormund is now 50 in his combat skill, old age. Ah. Ooh, Shield of the Tundra. Nice. Where are you? At court in Forktop. Where is Forktop? Ah, you're up here. Are you like a master at arms or something? Law speaker. Oh no, he's the law speaker. He's the fucking diplomat. And the goddamn Tullys are balling out and have said, you know what? The Northerners will take the wall, but we'll be the ones to range north and kill King Mance. So that's pretty convenient. And it's being led by Lord Hoster Tully. What a badass. What a badass. And just like that, Mance's armies are destroyed. But they survive, and they're marching to White Tree. Oh, shit. I didn't see this. Wildlands are attacking the north. The north? No, they're attacking East Watch. So, the survivors of this army, King Mance's survivors, are going to White Tree. And their movement is going to be locked. They're also running away. We're going to leave Castle Black. We're going to move these armies up here to continue the siege. And we're going to intercept King Mance's forces. And hopefully Eddard can deliver a... Okay, they don't want to pay. They're struggling to make ends meet with their coins, so we're going to give them tax concessions, because that's what I normally do. We're going to intercept this army, and hopefully we can kill King Mance. Jarnal of Greenguard has been a leal and able servant. I will honor him with a Stark heirloom. Nope, we're not going to do that. Arrange for his reward. It's only 15 gold. Yeah, go ahead. And hopefully we can deliver a, Rickon. Rickon, the steward. Maester Lewin has shared some of his latest ideas with me. I do not know much of medicine, but perhaps he's on to something. He has asked for some money to develop his theory further and write a book on it. Of course, advances in medicine benefit us all. Do it. And we have intercepted King Mance's forces. They have broken, and there's no Giant's Bane here to help you. Surely we get to fight King Mance. No. Let's go ahead and pursue. We'll take attrition, sure. We will take attrition. But killing King Mance is the most important thing right now to destroy the resolve of the Wildlands, because even if we retake the wall and King Mance lives, there's always the chance he could rebuild his forces. Okay, so now where is this guy? King Mance, reigning in the Fist of the First Men. So we have to go north. We will go north. Imprisoned by Chief Tormund of the Giant's Bane. All right. Go north, and we're going to take... We're going to take the Fist of the First Men. Is that where Dala is? No, she's in the Frozen Shore. We need to kill this guy. We need him to die, and then that will destroy the Wildlings. Destroy them for good. And sadly, we can't really, we can't really end the war until King Mance is dead. Maybe I should write a letter to Lord Wallace to try to convince him of my good intentions. A forthright message is what he needs. Ruler is leading troops. Leading troops in Night Valleys. Alright, we'll move here instead. We will move on and pursue the Wildlings. We'll hunt them across the lands. Lord Wallace wrote back to me, informing that he has taken notice of my interest in friendship. Excellent. Destroy the king beyond the wall. And we have retaken Castle Black and Shadow Tower. History of subjects has always fascinated me. Oh, we're still doing war focus? We'll change that eventually. We'll change that, because I think family would be better now. History of subjects has always fascinated you. Good. All right. Come on, give me a duel with King Mance. If we offer him peace, do we get to imprison him? No. Lord Jorah becomes independent. The wall shall be restored. Damn it. Reigning in the Fist of the First Men. All right. So every time we beat King Mance in battle, he just teleports back to the Fist of the First Men. We need to be here to capture him. So we might have to split this force up here. Oh, the Tullys are back. All right. We have retaken the wall. Good. And so now the wildlings are being pretty much swamped by the northerners. Let's get Rob up here. Rob and the Great John. Lord Brandon, we'll give you a fantastic education. Yeah, you know, you're crippled, so I don't really expect you to do a whole lot. Intrigue will be your game. That'll be your game. Oh, apparently the Tullys are going to capture him. Leading troops in the West Shelf. That's way over here, sons of bitches. Yeah, King Mance wasn't there. Now we pretty much have lost the ability to take King Mance. That's kind of shit. The Gorge. Where's Chief Tormund? Is he at court in Forktop? He's here, huh? Well, let's go here, I guess. I guess we're just going to have to occupy all territories if we're going to have any chance of killing King Mance. All right. Well, we've taken the wall. I think it is time that we go north. All forces converge on the Wildlands. We will take every last territory. We will root them out of every hole they're in. We will take every fort and every keep. And we will bring King Mance to justice for daring to upset the balance of the realm, for daring to threaten the Seven Kingdoms and humiliating House Mormont. But that, ladies and gentlemen, will have to take place in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. As always, this has been Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. I have been the Golden Joeblivion. And until next time, I will see you all later.